morning, guys.
Good morning.
It's 10:06. I'm not a fan of starting late, but hey, we just came from somewhere. Thank you for coming. It's a strike today. It doesn't feel like.
No, it doesn't.
Well, that's a great idea. Nobody strikes us, huh? It's from Bangalore. So, 14th meetup. I don't have the usual presentation that I used to do, but let me do that in a whiteboard or something. Okay? So, who knows who we are? Probably everybody, or we have new participants in the group. That's it? How many are new? Okay. Alright, so just a little bit of introduction about the place you are in for awareness. That's a 4-minute video clip. I'll play it from the YouTube and then we'll get started about Scrum Bangalore.
Traditional organizations have a structure of management with a strong focus on procedures and control. In our fast changing world, this is a model bound to fail. We are moving to a paradigm where you succeed by being responsive. A responsive organization is an organization which is strong on vision and culture, hires and keeps the best people on board, and has software at the heart of its business model. This also means a paradigm shift for C-level. Instead of being behind the steering wheel, they enable customers to take control over and facilitate the organization in order to serve the customer to the best of its abilities. The tasks of the CEO of a responsive enterprise are a combination of the traditional CEO and CIO roles. A responsive organization puts the customer at the center of its operations. This is because software combined with big data offers unprecedented capabilities to customize the service offerings to the wishes and requirements of the customer. First of all, software plays a big part in interaction with the customer. Second, a responsive enterprise makes brilliant use of the possibilities software offers to analyze the behavior of the customer. It creates insight, which leads to experiments. These experiments can be created and abolished at lightning speed due to the presence of a continuous delivery pipeline. So what does a continuous delivery pipeline look like? A continuous delivery pipeline consists of basically 6 stages. The first stage is the commit stage. Within this stage, the features are built, unit tested, and packaged. At the second stage, the automated acceptance tests run to validate that the package is doing what it is supposed to be doing, based on the acceptance criteria. At the third stage, the team validates if the product is working in an exploratory manner. Fourth stage in the process is to let a user group test the application. At the fifth stage, the product is tested in a production-like environment to validate the performance and to test if the product can handle a certain amount of load. In the sixth and final step, the product is in production, where it can be monitored, measured, and where experiments can be made available to a specific group of your customers. Developers are essential in creating and maintaining the software-driven business model. They are the engine of growth and are strategic to the existence of the responsive enterprise. But how do you create a company culture where developers are attracted to an organization like these are to a beehive? The key components of a responsive enterprise culture are employees that have unprecedented freedom to make decisions which impact customer experience. Employees that are stimulated and have the freedom to experiment. The successful experiments act as an input for a next generation of services that a responsive enterprise offers. A responsive enterprise is high on vision. It is not only a place to work, but a vehicle to make the world a little bit better. These cultural values stimulate low-level entrepreneurship, which leads to a strong focus on the customer. Sooner than you may think, every company will become a software company. Start your journey to become a responsive enterprise today. Awareness. We are transforming organizations into software-driven responses. of enterprises.
Okay, that's Perennis, that's who we are. But a little bit about Scrum Bangalore, I'll keep it short, we're running out of time. So back in 2010, when Scrum was relatively new in India, still haven't heard it so much back then, we looked at the Google searches that came for the word Scrum, and then most of them came from Bangalore, so hence the name Scrum Bangalore, simple as that. We manage our events through the Meetup website, so that is meetup.com/scrumbangalore. Simple vanity URL, and if everybody can remember that. And we have approximately 2,300 members. We call them Agilists. So if you are new to Agile, and if you want to know, or if you want to get a tag of Agilist to put in your resume, you can join our group. We'll give you the tag for free, Agilist. And we don't leave there. What we do is invite you to all our Meetup groups. You can come here and learn from experts that are sitting in the front desk and also at the back desk, and also some people in the middle. So it's a platform where we facilitate people that know Agile, people that are new to Agile, you know, come together, and then let's talk and let's learn about it. That's Scrum Bangalore in gist. All right? And we have free Wi-Fi. That's the free Wi-Fi. Password and the SSID are the same. And we also have a Twitter context, Concast. And if you want to tweet something about today, please use this hashtag. Alright? #ScrumBLR. So we can click that hashtag and then see the tweets that people have done. And Albert, with a couple of his friends, will judge who is going to be the winner. Albert, you want to come forward?
Thank you.
Albert is one of our community ambassadors because he has done a lot of work about the 8 category SEU points that you get when you come to Scrum Bangalore if you're aspiring for CSM, CSP, oh yeah, and all those things. Okay? There's a little bit of change in the agenda. The first talk is going to move to the second place and the second talk is going to move up first. My name is Modern, sorry. And if you find people running around with this t-shirt, then if you want anything, please ask them, okay? They're pretty friendly. You saw the response to Enterprise, right? Hires and keeps the best people. Okay, so I will come in between and then talk more about how the event is going to go. But since it's already time, I will invite our first speaker, Naveen, who's an Agile coach at LeanPitch. Naveen, are you ready? Okay.